Hello guys and welcome back to TNT Madness. Today we are on TMFactions and I'll do some proper intro stuff soon, but this is just the very start of the server. The server has actually been online for about 40 minutes, but I've just been sorting out a bunch of stuff, the server, trying to keep track of it, so in case something actually went wrong. So yeah, luckily no one knows my alt, which is alt_madness is actually me, so I'm not getting completely spammed. But there is currently 85 players online, and earlier there was 90, about 5 minutes ago, so that's really good. The server's doing really well at the moment. 85 is a lot of people, so that's especially for this point in time, because it's been open for 40 minutes. So it is going pretty well for the current situation. Also, for everyone wondering, I'm just currently on my alternate account because I'm monitoring the server at the moment to make sure it gets to a point where it's stable. So I'm just waiting for it to get up to 20 FPS currently, which is what when the server runs at the same that Minecraft runs, so you don't get any server lag. And I'm just waiting for that so that way I can actually start playing properly. And I'll probably be actually playing more tonight when there's less people on, but yeah, it's quite good at the moment. So I'm just essentially working on this at the moment, and I'll be, hopefully in the next clip you'll actually see me doing some factions. But I just want to record this moment to say thanks for everyone coming on the server. I hope you did enjoy at least the start. It's not a complete train wreck like it was last time. We actually got the server to not crash. Did a lot more prep. We don't even know why it went off complete last time. I think it was because of the custom train, but it went well this time. And yeah, resets normally have a lot of issues, but this time it seemed to go really well. So anyway, I'm going to probably start playing properly now. So hello guys and welcome back to TNT Madness. I know I've already done an intro, but now I am actually on playing. I'm not going to be playing properly until tonight, but I'm going to set up a temporary base somewhere. And after I've done that, probably either at the end of this episode or next episode, I'm going to probably join some major faction, because I just want to get myself set up and actually decide what I want to do for the whole season, because I plan on playing the server quite a lot. And also, I have now got this 5Zig mod, so up here you can see my extremely high ping and the player count online. So if I die in PvP, I can blame lag for when that happens. Also, the TPS is calmed down a bit, so the server is actually stable at 90 players online, which is really nice. So I mostly just wanted to go over a few things while I'm here. So the first thing is, I'm going to be playing at least the first bit as elite rank. So if I just go dot in the chat, you can see I'm elite rank. So I'm going to be playing as elite rank, which is the cheapest rank you can buy in store on shop.tmfactions.com, just so I can get some bit of a head start without getting too big of a head start. So I'll just go, I've already got kit starter, which is just a bunch of stuff, but I'm going to, because last week we had the server actually crash the way it did, there's a kit sorry. So if everyone that was online here last week, everyone got kit sorry, which is essentially a legendary crate key, a lot of people have already got. So that's what I'm going to be opening up now, and hopefully I'll get something decent. You can't really get anything too bad in this, but hopefully I get something that's half decent would be nice. Literally the worst thing I could possibly get in the actual crate key I got, so I must be unlucky. So I'll probably do that soon, but actually that's not too bad, because from a perspective of starting from scratch, that's going to go really well for me. So I'm just going to stick this in here, and also because I am elite, I have the bonus elite kit, which is just a god apple, a beacon, and a really good pickaxe. So if I was going to get spawners, unfortunately there's no spawners in the nether this season just to keep everything balanced, I would use that. And I'm just going to stick some of this stuff. See my lag? I don't know why my ping is so bad, but I just need to essentially stay away from PvP. And the last kit I have is slash kit elite, because the kits have got compacted now, so a lot of it goes into one spot. So I'm going to actually take off that diamond armor and probably enchant it later and stick on the stuff, which is just protection when I'm breaking one. So it's not fantastic, but it works pretty well for a start. And also in the elite rank, I got 20 grand if I would stop lagging out of my mind. Then I could get this. So I'll just keep a bunch of this stuff actually in my inventory, so that way later on I can actually use it. So, also because I've, I think 20k, yeah, 20k, plus 1,500 when you start, I can get some stuff from the shop when I'm actually going to play. So, that's all I really want to say at the moment. We also have a new duel plugin, which I'm probably going to be using to bet with people if they annoy me. But that's what I've got at the moment. Also, a few things I just want to talk about while I'm actually doing this episode is, one, I planned on using my blue snowball, but I actually am still waiting for my preamp that I ordered ages ago. It got caught up in customs, and that still hasn't arrived, so I also brought a blue ice core. So I should be getting one or the other, because you need 48 volts of power or something to power the blue snowball. So you need, not blue snowball, blue yeti, not blue yeti either, blue bird. So I need a phantom power or something like that. So I'm going to be hopefully getting that very soon, and then once I get that, you won't have to hear my raspy voice in the blue snowball. So it should sound a lot better, and that's just something that I want to do. Also, a lot of people have been asking me about what I plan to do with a cannoning series, and I want to actually get into hammers and all that, because I actually did a video yesterday on a 21 shot, but I just really want to get, you know, it as much as I possibly can about cannons before I actually go into a series, because if I'm going to do an informal series like that, I don't want to spread misinformation, so I want to just do it properly. So yeah, so I'm probably going to wait till my ping normally should hover around 300, so hopefully my ping isn't this bad and I won't get ghosting when I'm actually building blocks. But it's not actual server lag, it's just lag that I get from existing. So that's gonna be it for now, and next cut you'll see me building a base or something. So welcome back. So I am quite far out, of course I'm not gonna give away my coordinates. I've just found this really random island in the middle of the ocean. I thought, why not? No one's gonna find me here unless, well, they probably will. But since, if you didn't know, TNT is disabled for the first week, so people have time to build. So people can't actually destroy my area if they come near me. So I'm going to start here, and since it's a very stale server, the first thing that is very important to do is to make money. So you have to essentially farm. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to make a sugarcane farm, which is essentially the most popular thing to do when you start up. And then I'm going to do something a little bit different and make a semi-automatic cocoa bean farm and do that with some redstone. So hopefully I can get that done today. But I've just set up camp so far, and people can still open chests if they're in my general area. So I've got it set up so far that this is going to be my rare-ish chest, so if someone does find my land, they can't get it. So that means creeper eggs are also disabled. So I have a week to get enough money to do stuff, but luckily I have not really a week holidays, but I have a bit extra time because I'm off school, but I'm doing a bunch of other stuff instead. But I should have some time to do this. So what I'm doing at this very point in time is just currently, oh, is that wilderness? No, is of, I'm not going to go /F map either. I just don't want to give away my coordinates. As I'm making, well, this is the very edge of my land. I've got 100 power and I've claimed a 25 area. So I am just building a giant area here where I'm going to be doing sugarcane. And I'm just trying to find it so I can get to the very edge of my base. Also, if everyone's wondering, there's only 50 players on at the moment, but it is past midnight in the US, so I'm just assuming that most of them have actually gone off, because even Stampede, he's having internet issues at the moment, so he's not even online. So if you don't know, he's co-owner now. And also, what I was planning to do at the moment is to, in terms of me, my state of factions, is I'm planning on just getting myself half pie set up, and then either join a massive faction or go on my own. And warp the supply drop things wrong. A lot of people are going to get a lot of good things from that. Cool. Did I just reach the end? I might have just passed it. Yep, so I'm just building this slightly above the sea just so I can, just so it's easier for me. This is where I'm going to be making sugarcane farms, so. So, where is the edge? There it is. So, perfect timing. So, I'm just going to make the outside cobblestone, and then I'm going to be using the inside with dirt, and then filling it up with water. And hoping that goes all well. Another thing is, I'm hoping to get most of this video done today, because I want to play a lot today. It's already 4:30 for me here, and I still have quite a bit to do tonight, and I'm trying to get my Saturday video uploaded, or rendered, or lots of things, which I've got rendering on my other computer at the moment, which is in my closet. So I'm trying to get that sorted, and also, tomorrow is my birthday. I am turning 17 years old, which a 17-year-old playing Minecraft doing YouTube, it's quite good. I've been doing this for a while now, but turning 17, that's a pretty big milestone for me, so I'm going out tomorrow, so I won't be online, but it's just something that's very interesting, so I'm gonna try and not necessarily enjoy myself, but it's my birthday tomorrow, so I'm doing that. Also, since I'm playing as Elite, I have pee time, which is very, very helpful. And I'll be playing probably as Elite rank for the first while, and then depending on how far I get, I might change or just stay with Elite rank for the whole season. The only thing I don't get, though, is slash e-chest. Oh no, I guess I do. I think I'm currently opt. That might be why. Yeah, so now let's try. I was opt, yeah. Yeah, so I was opt because I was working on the server. I can't wait to see their boost comments. But at the moment, I'm just terraforming and working on this area. So this is going to be my little island. And if anyone has an actual name that they want for this island, then tell me in the comments below. I'll have a look, because I think that would be a fun idea, just name this island. So, the great thing about the moment is I don't have to worry about actually making my base because of the 1 week TNT thing we have. A lot of people seem to like it, but it just means that instead of actually raiding, for the first week we'll be grinding, and I ran out of cobblestone. So, good time to go to the shop. I still instant TP, I need to fix that. Normally it's 5 seconds. I'll also buy some sugarcane while I'm here. So what's my balance? It is 2200, so you can see other people are here too, so let's buy a ton of cobblestone so we don't run out, and probably some dirt, even though I have some just from when I was getting it. And while I'm here, I might as well get some other supplies. I'll grab some cocoa beans. You can sell 16 for 90 on here, so they don't sell for that bad considering the amount of cocoa beans you actually get, so I'll buy some of that, and I'll buy another stack of sugarcane. A lot of people have actually sugarcane farmed. I saw one guy that I was going to kill, but then he logged out the moment he saw me. So I also just get a stack of ender pearls in case I need them. So what's my balance now? 1500. So yeah. So one great thing now that I'm back on doing faction series is I plan on doing these at least once a week, hopefully twice a week sometimes. But since I'm back on here, I can actually do... Wow, my FPS is down 30. That's not good for a 60 FPS video. Is I can do time lapses. So I was planning on doing a third person time lapse, and for some reason I installed 30 FPS. This is very laggy. I'm going to do a time lapse. I was going to do a third person time lapse, but I don't think that is actually possible. So instead, I'm just going to do a regular seizuristic first person time lapse. So I'm just going to make some buckets now, so I can do water. I'll just use all. If you're wondering where I got my iron from, I got that from Kit Elite, which is one, you get 4 blocks, you can use the kit every 24 hours, which I'll be definitely taking advantage of, but it just means if I do this here, then I can use it for, bucket stack, by the way. They stack up to 16 if you're, and we don't have the glitch that we used to have. And AH, I wonder what's an AH at the moment. Oh, there's heads, that's cool. Use this for your trophy room, oh god. 10,000. Yeah, that's cool. Silk touch, 150,000. Yeah. Ooh, that's not. That would be good if I could get that. That's what I mean. Like, I'm sure the auction house will be quite popular this season. But that's quite nice. Yeah. So, I can't technically sell anything at the moment, but I'm sure protection for armor will get in there, and I'll probably end up selling some. And if I want to, I'll buy some. But I hope to do an enchanting session soon anyway. But anyway, I'm rambling. Let's actually get on with this time lapse. don't know how big of a time lapse that is going to be, but I was planning on having this being the most efficient way of doing it, but I decided that this is taking way too long, and I actually forgot how to do the most efficient way, which is very sad, which means a few things. It means this is by far not the most efficient way, and it looks god-awful. So I am just because I feel like time is a very valuable resource, I'm just going to do the normal lines of sugarcane instead. So I'm going to block this off with cobblestone and then do actual regular sugarcane, because that's honestly at the point I am now. And then hopefully I can actually properly start growing. Another thing I need to get also is lily pads for all of the water source blocks. But if you do it the most efficient way, which is most efficient way, which I'm going to have to look it up because I forgot, then it works. It looks really well and it works really nicely. So I'm going to continue working on this. It may not look like I've done much, but I've spent a good 10-15 minutes on here anyway. I'm back after, I think, nearly an hour now. That's how long it took to do that. Don't know how well the time-lapse looks, because I haven't edited yet. That'll be fun to do. But yeah, if I'm not used to making things, that it took a while. It took it longer than I expected. It took about half, I think, 50 minutes, which is not good, just to do that bit. So yeah, I either get easily distracted or I'm not very good at building things. But it looks nice now that I've done it. So now what I'm going to do is I'm going to place all the sugarcane down. I originally brought lily pads and my balance is now down to 7,800, but instead I brought some wool so I can make carpets instead. Yeah, my internet is not good. Can I not make carpets? Or am I... There we go. Oh, whoops. I just forgot how to make carpets. I am a special child. Oh, well. 5.5 stacks, so... I filled every spot with water, except this one. And it kept falling off some, or it was over here. Yeah, there's a start of a cobblestone thing there. So now I'm going to place down the rest of the sugarcane and place down all these carpets. The carpets, I did red just because red is one of my favorite colors. It probably won't go that well with this. Actually, it's probably going to look quite awful. Yeah, this is going to look really awful. Yeah, now I'm regretting picking red wool. I'm going to go back to lily pads for now. And then I'll probably find a different color, because I'll save these red carpets for something else. But that looks really bad. And I just realized I can just go /home. Yeah, there was also this other kid called Neek who just said he had a thing. Teleport to Arctic Space, I think that's what they're called. So I have TP to their actual base, so that's pretty cool. They're probably going to be watching this and monitoring me, so hopefully they won't do anything that will affect me. Do I have any dirt left? Yeah. It's actually a good idea to keep building blocks on me at all times, so I'll just take that and that. My ping, like, now I can say how bad my internet is, but it's just, my ping normally says around 300, but my internet is so bad that it's probably not, but... I'll just stick with the lily pads. So that's enough of me rambling. I'm just going to be finishing this. So I've used up pretty much all of my sugarcane, which I believe is 4.5 stacks. And sugarcane is not exactly cheap to buy. So the money I have left, I'm not going to be able to fill all of this up. But how much do I have left? I'm going to try and fill up most of it. So let's go back to the shop and see what we can buy. So 64 for 9. Yeah, it's quite expensive to buy, to be honest. Spell, I still want to buy some more lily pads. I'll spend the rest on lily pads. Okay, we'll see how much this gets us. So, yeah, time is ticking on, so... how... So, we are now at $0. So hopefully we can make some of that money back once some of the sugarcane actually grows. And the way I actually place it down, it's not as fun to place down in here, but I would go just run along the back here. It's super easy to place sugarcane down here, as long as I don't hit the back. And then I can just run across with my lily pads like this. It is so easy to place them. This is so easy, except for the fact that I have to stop occasionally, because lag. But just makes it so much easier to actually place it down. So I'm going to finish off the sugarcane farm, and hopefully we can get some money very soon. The thing is, sugarcane doesn't grow that fast, so I'm probably going to just stay AFK here for an hour, because I am quite a wee way out, so I don't expect anyone to actually find me. I'm not near the border or anything, I'm not that far out, but I am a wee way out, far enough away that I feel like I should be okay to AFK, but I probably will put myself in a hole later on too if I am going to do that, so. And tomorrow's my birthday, so I'll be away most of the day, so I can probably AFK then too, but that's why I might actually, instead of a semi-automatic cocoa bean farm, I might actually have a fully auto cactus farm, because I actually just did a video on that. Everyone's like, sugarcane's so much better to start off with. I'm not arguing with you there, I'm just saying as a farm to start off with, especially the fact you can AFK it, it's a really good farm. So that was pretty much the whole point of that video. But I think it's a good idea, so I'm probably going to try it, because everyone has their own opinions of what they think is the best, and yeah, everyone can have their own ways to make money. But I feel like there's lots of ways. Sugarcane is probably by far the best, just because it's the simplest to make. You can't make it full auto though. Yeah, so cactus would probably be the best full auto starting farm, but not the best overall farm. So also, for anyone wondering if I'm going to make a simpler design than the one that I actually did, no, I'm going to be actually building that one, because I actually don't think it's that hard to make. Like, it may take slightly longer, but on some of the other cactus farms you have to make, like even the string ones, you have to jump around and all that, and I fell off into this ocean already quite a few times, and I don't really want to be falling off all the time. If I have a platform for each one, then it's good. But this sugarcane, however, will be a good start, because I need 10 grand to buy a hopper, because cost 10 grand per hopper. And also, on F top, it's based on what you have in your faction, and hoppers are apparently over only 5,000. Last time I checked, they're 10,000, because they're only 5,000. I might be wrong. And Arctic, which is Stamps faction, has a silverfish spawner, which is worth 10 million, because it has no grinding value, so that's insane. He doesn't have any iron golem spawners or anything yet, which, thank God for that. So yeah, I've actually got a bit of sugarcane left, so I can't really think of anything else to talk about. I would like to get a cactus farm up, but I doubt I'm going to have time. I'll probably end up ending this video off soon after I've done the sugarcane farm, but I will actually, I'm almost certain that I'll be able to do a midweek video. And also, what do you guys want me to do in terms of length of videos? Do you prefer tons of talking and a longer video, or just progress updates, more quality but shorter video? Like, by shorter I mean like 15-20 minutes long, or something like 30 minutes long? Just, that would be a really good question that I would like to ask. I might even make a straw poll on that. But also, since I'm out of money, I'm just going to be placing sugarcane for all of that would have happened. I'm just going to be placing sugarcane for everything that we have here. And it is now, it is 5:30 for me soon, so I'm going to have dinner as well shortly. But it is 1 a.m. and there's 37 players online. It's not much compared to what we have, but it's a good start. And the fact that we have so many players means that we're going to have a much bigger player base, because TNT cannon mechanics work properly now. So I'm very looking forward to cannoning some bases. And since there are actually quite a few factions already, like Arctic, Carbon, I don't know, Vortex, Eden, There's quite a lot of factions already that are going to be really big, so I'm sure I'm going to get a lot of fun out of this, and I'm sure a lot of people are also, but it's just going to be a lot of raiding going on the server, so I'm sure it'll be a very interesting season and a good start, and that's going to annoy me. Where'd that shuriken go? Oh well, just wasted two shuriken. So I'm going to see how far this goes. And then I'm probably going to build myself a box AFK and see if any of the shuriken grows. And my ping is under 300. That... Okay, well, I jinxed it. Damn it. Oh well. The server is Arizona, and the way I get my connection is going through the Southern Cross cable. So I have really bad internet here. So the increase in ping is not because of the distance. It's just because of how bad my internet is. So that doesn't look too bad. We've got a massive spot here where we can put our spawners anyway. What tell me what to do and I can prove to you and I'm okay with PvP. I have no idea what he's talking about. PvP whoops. What? Anyway, so I'm just gonna leave that because I have no money at the moment and I'm gonna build a box. So, and then I'm probably gonna sit here for like an hour. Also, I'm probably gonna get my alternate account off admin mode or else I'm not going to use it any other than AFKing and for third-person time-lapse if I get that set up. So I'm probably just going to leave it in op mode because I'm currently not op. Or I am. God. I forgot. What? That doesn't make any sense. But I can feel the boost comments coming already. I'm just putting this around here so that way I can walk around this. But, what was I going to do? I get so sidetracked so easily. I'm just going to go dig myself into a little hole down here. You know, I'm gonna do it in the main part of the land. And then I'll come back in probably an hour or after dinner after this is all grown. And then probably for the next episode, I'll probably work on a cactus farm. So, I'll just go down sand and then place some dirt on top of me. So, goodbye world. Actually, before I AFK, I just realized I don't know if the auto-kick system is on or off, but either way, I don't really want to take the chance, so I'm just going to make a tiny little AFK system here, and for anyone that doesn't know, the way you make this is you dig two holes down, place down a fence post, and get some water. Make sure it's facing a wall, so if I go ahead and grab some water real quick. I'm just going to go slash home. Because I have two homes at the moment. Go down here and do this, and I'll stick this up like so. And then if I sit here, maybe it's actually one more up. There we go. And then I start jumping. So this is going to be my little AFK trap thing here. Well, not AFK trap, but I'm just going to stick some temporary blocks above here. And then once I'm done, I will mine them out. So I'll just stick this down like so. And then just AFK. So I'll see the world in just a minute. So I'm back, and the player count has really dipped down. It must be like 3 or 4 a.m. in the US at the moment, because it is currently 20 past 7 at the moment for me. So I've been off for around 2 hours. But all of our sugarcane has grown fully. So I'm just going to harvest this quickly, and then I can finish off this farm, or that's all I really want to get done. I might actually in the future, if I have time, make this the most efficient one, because it's so much easier to get sugarcane when it's like this than it is actually like that, but it really doesn't matter. I'm gonna need more inventory space. Luckily I have slash sell hand, because we've changed it so only donors have slash sell hand, which actually works fine at the moment. Well, it just means I have slash sell hand, but there's a giant billboard now in the shop, at the very back of shop, and I'm pretty sure there's a warp to it anyway, so it's not like it's hard to get to or anything either. But it's just something that is nice to give to donors. So, do I put sugarcane in there? No. I'm just gonna put these other two chests down while I'm here. Actually, I might have a sugarcane. Okay, well, like, and my ping's under 300, yay. Maybe that's because the server's not, doesn't have as much strain, but I might just stick the chest just on the edge of our little island and stick the sugarcane on and at the back here and just see how much we can actually sell it for, because that'll be interesting. So yeah, I'm pretty sure this video's already hit, like, I don't know, the 25 or 30 minute mark, so after I've actually done finishing this farm, I'm going to actually clean it up. But at least this time, releasing the server, nothing drastic went wrong, and the only real issue we had was the spawner problem, which, if you don't know what that is, essentially, it's just where the spawners break or something when it spawns. I'm pretty sure we can fix that for restart, but I've got scheduled restarts, so I'm not really worried about that at the moment, but Stamp's probably going to be fixing it soon anyway. So, yeah, this is actually really satisfying, just to destroy all this sugarcane. There's going to be an absolute ton laying around, but see, we've already got tons. And I'm probably going to leave this round, and maybe even get... I'd love to make a cactus thumb, because the first week I have, I'm probably either going to do two or three episodes this week, because the first week is, I essentially don't need a base to make money. So if I can get a ton of money straight away, right off the bat, then that would be great for me. So, yeah, I'm pretty sure most people in the America have gone to bed, and I'm sure when I come on next morning, it'll be, I don't know, up to 50 or something again. But, yeah, it's, today at least has gone pretty well, and I still need to actually get, I'm not actually going to be selling all of this because I have to plant down the rest of the sugarcane. So I'm going to come back now after I've planted down the rest. But from, like, that's just over half, we have got, gee, nearly a full inventory of sugarcane. So we'll see how much. It's $300 per stack when we sell it. So it's a good chunk of money that we should get. So I'll plant the rest and then I'll see how much we can sell it for. So I'm just grabbing the sugarcane they had in the chest, and amazingly we have exactly two rows of sugarcane, or 18 stacks, which the fact it's on 64 is quite amazing. So I'm still gonna do the actual lily pads for here, so again I don't fall through like that, but I'm going to go ahead and sell hand this and see how much it actually costs. So my balance is still zero. Yep, sell hand. Yeah, 5 grand, that's actually not too bad, considering after we have this, we'll probably go get close to an inventory full. So that's pretty much 10 grand per harvest, which, considering this is actually a pretty small sugarcane farm in terms of things, that's quite a good chunk of money. So I'm going to go to the shop now, buy some more lily pads, and be on my way. So I'm just got 3.5 stacks of lily pads. I don't actually know what my balance is. It is 2 grand. So yeah, I bought 3.5 stacks of that. So one thing I want to talk about, which a guy was asking me about yesterday, is just for question's sake, just while I'm doing this, is what games do you play other than Factions? And I think I did a Q&A like this a while ago, back when I was showing my awful desk setup. Rearranged my room a bit since then, so I might have to redo that at some stage if I get a better camera. But the games I play at the moment, the most I'm currently playing Minecraft. I'm still playing that the most, but I used to play CSGO an awful lot, and I still play that quite a bit, but the game I'm playing the most at the moment, other than this, is actually Overwatch, which is actually a really fun game. And Just Jack, who's a guy that was on the server before he charged back, was the guy who originally got me into that. So now it's a really fun game, I got it, and I just can't stop playing. It's a great game, and luckily they had servers in Australia so I can actually play on it, or it would be unplayable. But that has to be the game I'm playing the most at the moment, and it's just a fun game. If you've never heard of it, just, it's, you can't really go wrong. I'm a filthy casual, so games like that are great for me. However, something like CSGO, I love competitive. I'm only Nova 1 on that game, so I'm not that great at it, but it's still really fun, because when you play a game like that, it's, you get in what get out what you put in. So like, even on like this, I'm building the sugarcane farm, and because I built it, I am getting all the money from the sugarcane. So it's, I don't know why, I just like games like this. And I'm probably not going to have enough lily pads, so I'm going to have to go back to the shop again. But that is essentially what I had, so I'm definitely not going to have enough lily pads. But I'm going to, Oh, we already got sugar cane growing, so that's cool. I feel like a farmer. So, I have finished this farm, and I've still got a lot to do tonight, so that's pretty much going to be it for this video, but I understand that was a very rambly video and just all over the place, but we at least got this done. And I hope that in the future videos, I can do a lot more on the videos. So I have a lot planned for this season in particular. So if you want to watch the season, then you should subscribe now. And if you made it this far, then I'm sure you'll enjoy the series. So if you want more of the series, then please hit that like button. But that's pretty much all I have for today. I was going to say something else. AFKing. I was playing on AFKing, and I joined back on here when I was AFKing. But the one thing I've got is that the server schedule restarts. So I've set it to a schedule restart at 2 a.m. and 2 p.m. US time, and 7 a.m. and 7 p.m. my time. So, or I'm pretty sure, yeah, 7 a.m. 7 p.m. my time. So it is currently, the server must have restarted before then. So it'll be good for me to AFK at night, but that's probably why I got kicked a bit. So that might interfere with my AFKing and maybe yours, but yeah. But I think it's been a moderately productive episode, so hopefully next time we can actually get some more farms set up or start building a base or something. But however, what I really want to do next time is actually build a cactus farm. And also, I'm pretty sure this farm is really long across. But anyway, that's pretty much going to be it. So anyway, goodbye from TNT Madness.